Hello friends, in this video we will be discussing about the concept of string handling functions. Already some of the basic string handling functions we have discussed in the previous video. Now some of the more string handling functions which are available with the bundle that we are trying to understand today. So let's start with that. So first of all, we have seen four different string handling functions last time. That is strcat, that is used to concatenate the string. Second was strcpy, that is to copy the string. Third one was to compare the string, that is strcmp. Fourth one, that was strlen, that is to find the length of the string. Now here we are in the same line, we are having another functions. One of the function is strncat. This is little bit different than the strcat function. In strcat, it will concatenate both the strings. But here it is strncat. Means that only from the second string, only n number of characters. Only n number of characters will be added in the first string. In strcat we have seen that all the contents of str2 will be copied or will be added to the str1. But in this case what will happen? Only n number of characters from string 2 will be added in the string 1. Okay, so let's take an example that here we have s1 equals to hi and s2 equals to hello. So when we perform the operation of string concatenation, but here I have given the value of n is 2, means that only two characters, only first two characters will be added, so that you can see the output is hi and he. So output is hi and he. So this is the difference between strcat and strncat. Okay, in the same line we have strncpy. It performs the same sort of operation. Only the difference is n number of characters will be copied on the first string, so that the third parameter is added, that is integer n. Now if you look at the example s1 comma s2 comma 2, so only two characters will be copied. It means that the answer will be he. If we remove n, or suppose we write n equals to suppose 3, then answer will be what? HEL. Okay. So this is how the value of output is purely based on the value of n. Now strncmp. So here also it will compare only n number of characters of both the strings. So for example, here we can see that we have hi and hello. So both strings are not same, both strings are different. But just check out the logic. strncmp, s1, s2, these two strings we are going to compare. But the value of n is what? 1. It means that I am comparing only the first character or only one character. So if we compare only one character or the first character from both the strings, then it is h. So when we compare h of both the strings, so h minus h gives you 0, means that output is 0. So if you write the logic that we have discussed in the previous video, so as per that logic, both the strings are same. Actually, we can say this, okay, both the strings are different. But if in place of 1, I'll be writing 2. In place of 1, I'll be writing 2. Then answer will be what? That will be I minus E. So it will be the subtraction or the difference of the ASCII of I and E. So this is strncmp, and only n number of characters will be compared. Then next is strnlen. It means that it will be giving length, but length for only given n number of element will be compared. So this is these four functions are more or less on the same line, which we have seen in the previous video. Only the thing is n is added. So in previous video we have seen the functions, those are having two arguments, but here the extra argument is added, that is integer n. So everywhere in each and every function integer n is added. Okay, now let's take some more functions. So here we have seen strchr. Now what is the purpose of this? It is to find the first occurrence of character from the front. Means what? Suppose we have a string and we need to check out whether a particular character which I am desired to check is there in the string or not. For example, the string is hello, how are you? So I have written S1 comma O. Means what? I am trying to check whether the character O exists in the string S1 or not. Character O exists in string S1 or not. If character O exists in string S1, then it will return the whole string once the occurrence of that particular character is found. Means it will be checking the occurrence of O. So it will be starting from left side. So it will be, system will find the occurrence of O here. So output will be starting from this to end. So the output you can see O dot dot how are you. So wherever system will find the first occurrence, from that to last character of the string will be printed as an output. So this is just to check out whether the character exists in the given string or not. In the same line we have strrchr that performs the same sort of operation, but it will be starting from the reverse order, or it will be starting from the last character. So here you can see strrchr, it will be checking into string S. Okay, it will be checking into string S1. It will be checking for character O, but checking or screening will start from the right side. So it will start from the right side. So here the first occurrence of O will be found here. So your output will be, sorry, this is not the output. Your output will be this O, U and question mark. Okay. So the difference between strchr and strrchr is that strchr starts searching for the occurrence of character from the left side, whereas strrchr will search for the occurrence of character from the right side. And once the occurrence is found, from that particular location to end of the string will be printed as an output. Now next is strstr. So strstr is to check the existence of substring in the main string. So here your second string is considered to be the substring and this is the main string. So it will check whether S2 exists in S1 or not. Here we were checking about a single character, whereas in the case of strstr we will be checking about the string, whether the string S2 exists in S1 or not. So here you can see hello, how are you. Now in this case we have written S1 and the second substring or the second string is R. So it will be checking whether this R, this particular string exists in this main string or not. If string found, so from that particular location to end of the string, everything will be printed. So you can see that in output R, U and question mark will be printed on the screen. So this is your output. And the last one, that is A2I. This is important function whenever you are working with string manipulation. Suppose you are working with file management and so, this can be very useful. That is A2I function. Now what it does, it will convert the string into integer. So it will take one string as an argument and it returns integer. So it may be possible that many a time we have stored a number as a string and afterwards we need to use that number as a number. So in this particular scenario, this function is very useful. For example, here you can see I have printed percentage D, means I am printing number. Now if you see, the argument is what? Argument is a string, because 1, 2, 3, 4 is written, but it is surrounded with double quotes, means this is string. So whenever I am giving 1, 2, 3, 4 string to A2I function, this A2I function will convert the string into integer and it returns 1, 2, 3, 4 as integer. And then after, you can able to perform all the operations which you can perform on integer on this particular value. So these are very basic string handling functions, and this can be useful for string manipulations. So I hope you understood the concept. If you have any doubt regarding this, you can write me on 6102@gmail.com. Thank you for watching the video.